Hi dear chordates, now in this video now we will discuss phylum Chordata. First we should know what is the features or characters of phylum Chordata. The presence of notochord and second one presence of narochord and third one presence of pharyngeal gill slits. These are the characters of phylum Chordata. Next, phylum Chordata is divided into two groups. One is acraniata and second one is craniata. Acraniata is also called protochordata and craniata is also called eucordata. Acraniata is come under the lower chordata and craniata is come under the higher chordata. What is acraniata? Acraniata means, a means absence. Craniata means skull. Absence of skull is called acraniata. And this is also called protochordata. Why? Proto means primitive. Primitive chordates. That's why this is also called protochordata. And then what is craniata? Craniata means presence of skull is called craniata. Next, the acraniata is again divided into three subphylums. One is hemichordata, second one is urochordata, third one is cephalochordata. What is hemichordata? Hemichordata means, hemi means half. The words itself indicates hemi means half. Half notochord is present. That's why this is called hemichordata. What is urochordata? Uro means tail. Chordata means chord. Urochord, notochord present in the tail, in the larval stage, but not in the adult stage. This is urochordata. What is cephalochordata? Cephalo means head. And cephalo means head. Means the notochord is extended from head to the tail. This is called cephalochordata. In this cephalochordata, the notochord is present in larval stage and as well as adult stage. This is cephalochordata. But in urochordata only, the notochord is not present in the adult stage. Next, the craniata. The craniata is, the subphylum of craniata is vertebrata. Vertebrata. What is vertebrata? The vertebral column present in the backbone. Sorry, the backbone. The presence of backbone is called vertebrata. Means vertebral column. Vertebral column. All vertebrates are chordates. But all chordates are not vertebrates. Next. Because vertebrates means in this urochordata, notochord is absent in the adult stage. But that's why all vertebrates are chordates, but all chordates are not vertebrates. In vertebrates, again two divisions are there. One is agnatha and second one is gnatha stomata. What is agnatha? H means absence. Gnatha means jaws. Absence of jaws is called agnatha. In agnatha, one class is there. There is no super class in agnatha. Only class is there. That is cyclostomata. Cyclostomata means there is no jaws. Without jaws, the mouth is formed. That's why the for example of cyclostomata is petromegeon. Petromegeon is also like fish. Petromegeon is a fish. Next, gnathostomata. In gnathostomata, gnathostomata means presence of jaws is called gnathostomata. In gnathostomata, two superclasses are there. One is physis and another one is tetrapoda. Physis means fishes. Physis means fishes. In fishes, again two classes are there. This physis and tetrapoda is a superclass. Again, this superclass fishes under two classes are there. One is chondriotics, one is osteotics. In chondriotics fishes are, for example, torpedo. Torpedo is a produces electricity for protecting from the predators. Torpedo produces 22 200 250 volt of current for protecting from the predators. That's why it produces some electricity. In osteotics, for example, osteotics example is labiorhoita. We will discuss in the further videos in deeply. Next, what is tetrapoda? Tetra means four. Poda means limbs. Presence of four limbs is called tetrapoda. In tetrapoda, again, four classes are there. One is amphibia, second reptilia, Aeons and Mammalia. Amphibia. Amphibia means, ampi means two. Bia means the organism which lives on, which lives both, means lives on water and terrestrial. This is called amphibia. It lives aquatic and as well as terrestrial. This is called amphibia. For example, frogs. Frogs lives on terrestrial also, in water also. Next, reptilia. Reptilia. What is reptilia? Amphibia is a poikilothermic. Poikilothermic means it changes the temperature according to the environment. And reptilia is also poikilothermic. And it scales are present on the skin. This is classified as a reptilia. For example, turtles, snakes, and crocodile. These all are the come under the reptilia. What is aves? Aves means birds. Aves is the homeothermic, means it cannot change the temperature, which maintain constant temperature. This is called aves. We come, for example, parrot, duck, these all are example of aves. Next, what is mammalia? Mammalia means the presence of mammary glands, means it nourishes the young ones by producing or by giving the milk from the mammary glands. This is called mammalia. For example, woman, cow, dog, the monkey, these all are the mammalia. Further, we will discuss one by one in further videos deeply. Thank you. If you are happy with this knowledge, please subscribe our Acquire Knowledge channel. Thank you.